Okay, so what I have here is another one of my minis. If you can see, it's very small. And it is wood. And we're gonna be using oil today instead of the usual acrylic. Now it's a little bit harder to use the oil to do. So I'm just gonna start putting the oil in, and I kind of roughly sketched where I want my birds. This is gonna be a scene of birds on a fence post, maybe like in a summer field somewhere. So it's a little bit harder with the wood. It's rough and it's a bit porous, but oil is thicker than acrylic, so you can get a lot on with one coat. And what I am doing is I'm using my paints with just a little tiny bit of medium for oils, just to thin them out a little bit, make them spread a little better. Okay, so I'm just trying to get it thick in here. And I want to go all around the birds. So of course we can overlap this guy with the birds, so it doesn't matter if I go over them a little bit. And I'm gonna go over the wood here that we've drawn. Actually, I've gone too far over it. This is where the wood ends. Okay, I just want to get this sky filled in all the way around. The nice thing with the oil is I don't have to rush, because I know I can just take my time and come back and blend clouds in however I want to. I have plenty of time with the oil for blending. And that's really a nice part of working with oil. That's why it's worth the extra trouble. Okay, so I'm just mixing some more paint here. I just mix with my brush right on my palette. And just come in here. Now, of course, this is a rough sketch of the bird. We're gonna make it look a lot better when we start using paint, of course. Right, and I've got two birds. One sitting on the wire, one sitting on the post. Okay, so I'm just filling this in a little thicker here. I can see the wood through, so just going back with a little bit more paint. And I'm just being careful to go around the birds because I don't want them to have any kind of blue tint underneath them. I want to make them their whatever true color I decide to make them. I've been looking up some birds, of course, online. Saw some pretty ones with orange and blue in their body. I think I'm gonna go with that. So I really don't wanna mess up that orange, where that orange is gonna be. Not really worried about the beaks. They are gonna be hanging out over the sky there. That's okay. Right, so these are just really rough sketches though. I'm not good at drawing. That's the nice thing about painting. You don't have to be good at drawing. You can paint very well without being a pencil and pen artist, which I've never had that skill, so. Okay, so you can see we're mixing it in here. Getting this color in here. Okay, and then there's this little space here where there should be sky showing through, where their feathers are hanging. So what I have here is this bird's feathers are coming down to here and this bird's are crossing this way. And you'll see it a lot clearer once I finish the picture. Okay, so I'm just getting a little more paint here, making this a little thicker. I got a little too thin. And I'm just using a round brush. And I can't even tell what number it is anymore. It's too old. And this is a brush that, you know, I've let it wear out, which is fine because it's good for scrubbing. Now I'm going to take some white paint and I want to come in here and put some clouds in. So I'm going to, let's say, put some variations in here and here. And so right now I'm just putting in where I want them. Okay, so with oil, you just drop the colors in. Right. And I'm gonna make them all different shapes. And so now I'm gonna switch brushes, and I have a brush I like to scrub with. And it's dry. So I'm gonna come in here and just softly feather these out, because right now I just want this soft fading away of the clouds. I'm just mixing it in. I'm gonna keep wiping off on my paper towel as I get more paint on the brush, because I'm gonna keep this brush just dry, mixing the two colors. To kind of fade off, mix in. I just want the, you know, the softness of clouds, the haze in the background. That's all I'm going for right now. Just mixing it in with the blue. And then I'm going to come with more detail on these clouds. So these are really just a background. And I can see over here, I need more paint. It's a little too thin. So I'm gonna wipe off that white. Come back in here with more color in the sky. Let's blend in a little better. And you can still see the wood through it, and that's just too much medium. So I wanna cover that up. This is going to be barbed wire that these birds are sitting on, or one of them. I have a square brush. Right, this is a soft brush. This is a one-stroke Donna Dewberry. And I like her brushes, especially for oil. They're very soft. So they're nice to use when painting in oil. Okay, and I'm just going to start putting in this fence. And I got a lot of black mixed in here, which is okay because I want a lot of dark in my fence as well, my fence post. Okay, and I want this to be really old wood. I'm not trying to make it like a new cut fence post. No, I want this to be old. I want to have a knot in here. Okay, so I'm not gonna go over every bit of space with the dark color, because I do want some lighter colors to be in there. Okay, but it is choppy and old wood. It's weathered, it's been out there for a while. And so you're gonna come in with this dark color, and it's good to come in with the darker color, because we're gonna come with lighter colors on top of this. And we'll do them a little thinner. All right, so we'll take a little lighter color. Bring some in here. Let's see, I'm just gonna bring it in some places, and where I left it, fill those in. Yep. That's how I get the mixture. But I wanna bring some browns in here as well, and I don't want these so pointed at the top. I want it a little fatter. I want some pointed, but more of a squared. So I'll do a little choppiness there. And this is going up under the bird, kind of gonna have the hairs coming down over that. Okay, so now I need to get brown. Alright, I'm just gonna start bringing some in here. Okay, and I just keep in mind that, you know, our fence post is kind of jagged wood that's lined. Okay, so you're always gonna have something kind of lined. And mix a little in here. Just keep it in mind going down in these straight lines. Okay, now I'm gonna mix a little ochre. Mix that with my burnt umber. And come in here and put some of that in as well. And I just start to get the different variations in the wood. and the ochre really helps to do that. Okay, now I need to go back and put some of the black in. I wanted a knot about here. So I have a, I'm gonna go around that with some brown. I just wanna put the black in there. And I'm gonna have a lot more black like eating down into this wood here, kind of messing it up. And little really tiny shorter lines over here on the side because they're going around the side. So I'm not gonna see those spots as thick. Okay, those are gonna be a little smaller. And it's nice using this square brush. You see, I can make these look, I wanna put like a really deep ditch in here. There, you see, and I just taper it off and maybe have a little jagged, maybe have the dip come over here a little. And the wood's just all broken up. But the black really adds that depth that you want. I want a little more broken up here at the top. And so maybe make that wider and bring to a V. And then also you want some dots. So I'm gonna put just some dots of the black here and there and just sink it in a little. Okay, like that. And maybe just some pieces. Yeah, keep this black down here going. And a piece here. And I'm gonna have more light on this side, so let me go back over here and I'll even bring like a big patch of the black back here. Remember, this is oil, so it's wanting to blend. So for me to keep it on top, I have to get some thick paint here and put it in. Keep it showing. I'm gonna have it go kind of deep there. Right, and bring in some more around this edge back here, this back side. Alright, so I've got this knot that I want to do here, and I'm going to very precisely do a circle around that. And that's when I'm going to bring in a lot lighter color. So I've got this sinking in here. I've got this, I need this a little deeper. It's going to be that big, it's very deep black. Right, and then sink it in here. Make sure I have enough black on there. So it really looks deep. That's where you want to go ahead and go in with those details. Don't leave them out. Okay, so now I'm starting to get the desired look I want. I think I need a little more black in here. Really want to keep that aged look to the wood. And I'm gonna square that off a little more. Okay. And that's a little. Okay, all right. So that's good with my black. Now I'm gonna take a square brush still, but it's a lot smaller. I think this is a zero, it's a number two. Okay, number two flat. This is also a Donna Dewberry one stroke, different set, because it's a darker green. And I'm gonna take my white and mix it in with my burnt umber. Okay, so I'm trying to make a lighter brown here that I can come and outline a little more with. So I'm gonna need a bit of white. I really wanna get it, but I'm gonna add a little yellow ochre to still keep it more on the brown side than a pale side. Okay, now I'm gonna try and see. This might be too wet. I'm gonna put it around this knot. Okay, so you can see it's wanting to blend in. It's not easy to keep going with the oil on top. All right, so we're just gonna bring this up. Okay, so now I've got my knot and I wanna bring in some more of this color. Where I wanna put this color, this lighter color, is right next to where we put the black. Okay. Bring it in here, bring it down, And that's why I like this little tiny brush. I'm trying to keep it right on the tip. All right, and bring it in here. And I'm gonna have more lighter going towards this side. So right next to this black, I'm gonna bring it in again. There we go. And bring it around these dots I put in. Right next to this. Okay. And let's bring some more down here next to this side of the black. Yep. Here. Right along here. Okay, a little on this back side. Just a little. Okay, now I'm gonna bring a lot lighter color right up front here. Okay, I'm gonna indicate the sun's really shading it on that side. So I'm gonna take that same light brown, I'm gonna add a bit of white to it, really lighten it up. Okay, and I'm gonna come in this front side here, and I have a lot of paint on my brush because it's oil and it's gonna blend in. Side, right on this edge. Okay, and still that's not even light enough, so let me lighten it up even more. Get a little too much on my brush, right? And I'm gonna bring in right here. I'm not killing that whole other medium color. I'm just coming in here and lightening it up a little. Of course, I don't want that to look like that. Let's bring that down. Okay, bring in a little more highlight. See, I've got to push it back down to the edge of my brush. It's good old oils blending together. So you only have a couple strokes with this before you have to go fix it again. Okay, I may have a little too much black here, so I'm going to go over that a little more. Yeah, see how I'm starting to get more of the texture that we want. And then up here, I'm just getting a few highlights at the top. We're going to have most of that lighter color right up front here. Now I am, on this knot, going to have that lighter color showing because this knot's really sticking out, especially the very edge around the middle. So we want to lighten that up. Okay, and the same thing right on here. Hopefully I have enough left on the brush to do it. Let's see. Oh, I don't want to go in the black part there. Okay, now that notch really starting to come to life there. And I'm going to do a few highlights here because this would be sticking out too. And see, when I'm doing this now, I am grazing. I'm not pushing real hard. And that's why I have to keep loading this brush, getting it to the very edge, so that I'm able to do this. Okay, like this is sticking out here, so we need to have a little more light on it. All the stuff that's facing the front, it's gonna be more lit up. Okay, down here, we're gonna light this up a little more. There. Okay, now I'm starting to get that feel, that look, because back here, we're not gonna have as much. All right, so we've got that going on. Now, we're gonna have a staple right in the wood, and from that staple there's gonna be a little bit of rust. So I'm gonna wipe off this brush and we're gonna put that staple in real quick. Okay, the staple for the, this is for the barbed wire. Okay, so the staple for the barbed wire we'll put right here. Want to get like a rust color here, so I'm just gonna try and wash in a little rust, yeah, coming out of it. And right at that edge, I want to put a hard I'm gonna put a hard black on the side of this thing. Let's dig in the wood there a little where that's... We'll have to wait. Now we can start filling in the birds though. And the top bird, okay, both of them will make the same kind of bird. And this one, so the top of the head, we're gonna have like a dark blue back here. So this part back here is gonna be dark blue. And it's just gonna kinda shadow in with the orange. Okay, so I'm just gonna pull where that orange is gonna be and then pull this down. And keep pulling it in because we're going to blend that into the orange. Okay, but this is the blue till about halfway, till about here. Okay, and then the top of the head of the bird is a blue. So I'm just going to bring it around, bring that shape of the bird down. Okay, and then we're going to have the beaks coming out of here. It's gonna come back in here. And then this down here, right under there is white. So I'm just gonna go from about where the beak ends, and this is all blue, and we'll put the eye in later. Okay, so this should come down kind of sweeping. Alright, and then we have the orange. So I'm gonna block in the orange now down. So I'm going to go ahead and put the darker orange in first because we'll go on top with a lighter orange to give it depth. So we'll go in with this darker orange. Okay, and we'll just feather it that way. Bring it down here. And most of this, just that little bit is white there. The rest of this is going to be orange. And then we've got some blue on the outer wingtip. So we'll bring this down, feather this in here. And then this feathers down. This is going to feather into white. And this kind of just shoots all the way down. Out to about there. This goes a little tiny bit here in between the white and the blue. And that's the orange. That's it for the orange on that bird. Okay, and then we'll do this one later. Alright, so again, that's going to have to be a layer. That's going to be the first layer. It's the thing with oils. We're going to layer this painting. And we'll have to come back with details. So these are our first layers. Alright, now I'm going to take a number 0 brush. Okay, so you can see how tiny this little tip is. Very tiny. And I try not to mess that tip up. I try and take very good care of this tip. Because I need it. Of these tiny pictures. Alright, so I'm just gonna go into the black and I'm gonna attempt here, hopefully we don't mess up the whole thing, to get the eye in. Now the first thing I'm gonna do is try and get this beak in. Okay, the beak, remember, you gotta stay very small, and it's gonna come to a shape where it comes back like this. Okay, so we're doing a almost like an arrow back here. It's very tiny, so it's hard to see, but it is there. All right, and now, so the eye, if this is the arrow part of the back part that comes to that point, the eye is above it, okay? But there's enough of the head behind it that we got to be careful not to take up too much space with the eye. So I'm really just doing the tip of this brush for that eye. That's how tiny we have to get. We maybe could do it just a little tiny bit bigger. I may even have to cut that down. That might be too big. Okay, so you can see how that's gonna go. Alright, and the bottom of this beak is the darkest, so we're gonna be lightening the top up a little bit. I can try and do it now. I have a feeling it's not going to work. But I can try. So I'll put a little bit of lighter color on there, and I can already tell it's just not gonna happen. Okay, so we just wanna touch the top of that beak, and that's really enough. Just need to lighten it up a little bit. And this back part of the eye, right underneath it. And I'm trying to just barely bounce along the painting here under the eye. I don't even know if I'm touching it because my eyes aren't good enough anymore. Yeah, I went over the eye too much. Okay, but wouldn't it just lighten up right underneath that eye and even kind of pull this back? But we'll have to work on that some more. Okay, and then right under here is white. So we're just gonna, I'm gonna dot it in so it just kind of mixes in here a little bit. Yeah, just wanna dot it in. Yeah. Okay, and then I'm gonna keep taking that white and come down here. So here I'm gonna just start moving some white onto here. And actually you can even tint this a little bit. So if I put a little brown or a little blue in it, whatever, just to give it a little darker tint than pure white, because we'll come over with pure white highlights later. Okay, so I'm adding like just a tiny bit of brown, bringing it down here, and this is where his belly just kind of comes across the wood there. And then we're gonna have more dark blue coming down here. And let me get a little more brown in this. Then there is a very dark ring there. So let's try and put that in. It's really kind of like right here. All right, and then we can just go ahead and pull the blue up, because that's how it kind of blends off that dark line into the white. And then it also blends this way, so I can get a little more dark, darken that again. Okay, and pull it down. But really, that line needs to be very defined on this type of bird. So I'm gonna put it back in there and just pull a little bit. Okay, and then maybe just pull a couple across it to break up the line a little bit, but that's it. Okay, the rest, I'm just gonna do this blue tinted white, and it comes down like this into like a V. Okay, and then the rest of this is gonna be that really sharp dark blue. We can add a little bit of blue or blend a little bit of blue into this light, this white over here, because it's shadowed. It's really like a shadowed side of white. So we're gonna indicate like it's a white. And maybe I need to get a little more white in it there. But it's very shadowed. And it has some pockets of, as I'm looking at the real bird, has some real pockets of dark in it. Okay. Couple here, maybe pulling out this way, another dark spot here, and definitely darker back here. Alright, so, and a very dark crease just keeps coming. And then you can just blend those out a little bit off to the sides. Yeah. Again, I feel like I'm losing this. You know, we're gonna go over it with a little more tinted white feathers. This is just an under layer. Now we can take the darker blue and come down. This under tail here is very dark. So we come down like that and go ahead and outline this. Now first he has a darkness that comes out here. Okay, so it comes out, kind of feathers out this way. Another one that kind of comes down right in here. Right. Feather that up into there a little bit. And then this should actually be lighter in between these two areas, which I'm losing, so feather these up, pulling these up like I do with the round brush, where I lay it down and then pull to thin, so to get that look. All right, so I'm gonna take a little bit of the white before that I'd mixed with the blue, and just bring those sections back in this tail. Okay, you kind of put those in there, and then right on this edge is a highlight. So I can try and get that in there. Now, I'm gonna have to wait till it dries to do that. That's the thing with these minis, you know, and oil. You gotta remember that the layers take time. All right, so now this dark blue comes around this outside here. We got a hole in the wood there. There we go. All right. And just really meets that neck there. Okay, and keep going with that dark blue. And I'm gonna pull like feathers. Even though we're not really gonna see these feathers, I'm gonna pull them because, and I'm gonna bring this right down. You know, it comes all the way down, kind of curves in, all the way down. And I'm gonna actually pull the highlight in like that, and then you're gonna see those feather strokes a little better. So if I pull this in, and I'm just gonna go ahead and connect it all. Okay, now I'm gonna come in with my light blue that I'm mixing with the white, and I'm gonna just try and do this highlight right on the edge. And this is highlight out here, but I want it to just be a light blue. All right, so it's just a highlight on this darker blue. Now, it's mixing in too much, so I'm gonna come back with the dark again and pull it back out into it. Okay, so I'll have to let that dry. We do wanna pull in like this to give the indication of feathers. All right, so some, just pulling in a little. And I'm gonna come back again with an orange. Okay, so with the orange, I'm gonna really add some medium, okay? So I'm hoping that it will go on top of this blue. Yeah, there we go. Now it's picking up the blue though. I wanna pull these feathers over the blue a little more, okay? And I wanna pull them into, pull them up slightly into this. All right. Just a little. Actually, I want to pull them into this white a little bit too. All right, and really just need to let that dry. I'm trying to do too much. I can take my dry brush that I was using earlier. Okay, and try and blend out a little bit of this first layer, especially where I was just shading here. So we'll pull that out. We'll leave that layer till we can get back to it after it dries. Okay, so we can do the other bird and be about done with our first layer all together. All right, so let's move over to the other bird, which is the same color scheme. So I'm gonna start right out with that dark blue and just start putting it in. In on the head here. Now this one is gonna be a little, it's about the same angle. They're sitting about the same way. Okay. He may be facing sideways a little more, or facing us a little more, I don't know here. I think he's, I drew him facing us a little more. Okay, all right, so let's pull this around. And again, it's gonna come down part way and blend into orange and white. Okay, come back this way. Right, and then we've got the back of the bird coming down this way. So just putting that first layer, blocking in the colors. Of course, we're gonna have to come back with more detail, and this wing is actually a little bigger. And should come down behind his tail feather here. So we'll go ahead and make it this thick here. And just gonna pull down the ends of it there. Okay. Now, I'm gonna take a little bit of white. There's a shine on their heads where the sun's hitting them. So I'm gonna add a little white right up front here, going up the way that it turns up there. Okay, so this is just a little shinier. Okay, it looks like two stripes. Gonna blend that together. Okay, and we're gonna try and get that beak in there. Okay, so the beak is coming out about here. I'm trying to just keep it on the point. The beaks on these birds just curve up just a tiny, tiny bit, and it's about impossible for me to do this small. I would like to, but I don't know if I'm gonna be able to. Okay, and so here's his, I'll put the eye in. I don't know if you can see that very well. Okay, I need to lighten up the hair actually around him, around the eye especially. So I'm gonna move some blue-white into this dark. All right, now I'm gonna try and blend it with this brush. I just kind of wiped it off. And I'm trying to pull it into here. Now, really, the very back side of this one, because he's supposedly facing more sideways, is darker. So we can put a lot more of the dark just along the back here. Okay, and you know what? I think we need his head just a little more round. There, that's better. Okay, and we'll leave that and touch that area up and the eye up later. Okay, and let's get into the orange. So the orange is coming along here. And remember, we gotta leave a little bit of room for white right under. Okay, so we wanna come back in with some of the white. Okay, and just start filling it in. And it's okay if we mix some with the blue. But we really just want to get more orange in, actually. This is not coming down. Oops. Not coming far enough. Alright, let me get some more orange on here. Remember, too, that this is just the first layer. We're going to come back with a lighter orange later. And we really need a blue back here. This should all be blue. And this should be kind of a dark blue. And then we need just a shading. Of blue. Okay. And I'd like to add, if we can get a little bit of white around this eye, it would be good, because birds have white right around their eye, which is not easy to do. So I'm gonna try and put it in. I'm probably gonna have to go back later when it dries and make it thinner by creeping in a color towards it. That's kind of how I do with these tiny, tiny pictures. This one, in the real life picture, you can see more of the white around the eye. So I'm just tapping it in around the eye. Okay, and what I have to do to make that thinner is come back with the blue of the head and bring it in again close to where I put the white, trying to minimize how much. See, it's not easy, especially when your eyes aren't that good anymore. So you got, it's a little bit of work there to get that white in there where it belongs. But it really needs to be right around the eyeball on birds. Okay, so I have that in there, and I don't feel like it's enough. I'm just gonna pull some more back too. Alright. Really put it in around there a lot, especially on this one. And he has a lot of highlight up front. Ah, jeez. Okay, so now let me show you how to fix a mistake like that. I'm just gonna take medium and try and remove what I just did. Not good. All right, so I'm gonna come back with blue to fix that. That sucked. Alright, bring this back around. And I'm gonna have to fix the beak. Bring that beak back. Okay, and we need just a highlight on the beak, which is gonna be just a touch. Okay, so I'm just gonna try and touch a tiny bit of paint onto the beak. Like that, and leave it. Okay, and then I'm gonna go ahead and black that eye again on top of the white. Okay, so there. Now that sets the eye on top of the white. All right, so we're gonna leave the birds alone for a while. They need to dry. And we're gonna go back to the clouds, okay? So now I'm gonna take this scruffy brush that I was rubbing with, and I'm gonna take some of my white that I've blended with blue, and I'm gonna go in here and just add a little more detail to the clouds. But what I'm gonna do is just kinda, what I want is like a whole bunch of stuff going on. I want these to be like puffs, but I don't even, I mean, this painting's so tiny that I just want to let these frayed bristles hit and kind of determine it. Some of it's hazy behind there, some of it's not. Let's bring in these tiny cloudy details. I'll bring some coming in down here. Okay, and then I'm just gonna smooth them. So I'm gonna dry this brush again until I feel it on my hand nice and dry. And I'm really just gonna softly touch where I've added paint. Okay, I'm just kinda, this is a dry brush, smooth out. Okay, so it doesn't look so dotty, but it's very tiny details to clouds. Oh, smoothing a little too much. Okay. There, I really just want to get smoothened it out. Put some bright details here and there. Remember, with these tiny, tiny paintings, we can't really do the kind of big clouds you're used to doing. You're doing Barbie clouds now, okay? It's a thing. I always think of what would look good on Barbie's wall. I'm a Barbie collector, and I would love to paint paintings for like a permanent home for her that I could set up in my house. I would just love that. Okay, and I really want to fluff them out towards the edge here. So that's what I love about oil. Look at how we can just keep blending this stuff. fluff them. I could bring them out a little more. I feel like I need a little more towards them this way. More back this way. A little more up this way. I just keep pushing it around. Maybe soften this out a little bit there. Okay, so now I want to put the barbed wire in so I know where it's going to be, and I may have to redo it. So I'm going to go back to this number 2 flat square Donna Dewberry brush. See how flat I can get that? I can get a chisel. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get a chisel and the barbed wire. I'm going to first lay in where it's going to be in total black. Okay. Definitely gonna have to come over with other colors. You know what? They're gonna have another pin like there. So pretend like they stapled it twice. Okay? And I'm gonna put a little bit of that red color on so we know where that's a pin and not a piece of the wood. Okay. Alright, now let me go back to my total black. I'm gonna do my black first. Alright, so the barbed wire is gonna come across this tail. Alright. And I'm not gonna drag it because I don't wanna move any of the paint. I'm just kinda tacking in where I want this wire to be. All right, I'm gonna make it more solid later. I'm just pounding it in right now. All right, and it's gonna come across here between these two pins, or staples. All right, and then turn this. Come out this side. Okay. This side. Off this way. Okay, just so I know where it's gonna be. That's all. I'm gonna have to do a lot more work on that. But at least we have a good idea. And now we can see our staples going through it really well, which we'll work on when that dries later. Okay, so here's our barbed wire, and we'll put the spiky things on it later. I'm gonna let this dry. I'm not gonna try and do all that right now. Okay, all right, so we know where the barbed wire is going. Now we're gonna put in a couple we would have some grass pieces down here. We can put in a few of them now. And I'm gonna use the zero brush again. And what I'm gonna do for this, I want those to be kind of light colored. So I think I'm gonna take a little bit of yellow ochre and take a little bit of cad yellow and mix those together. I may put a hint of blue in there so it gets a bit of a greenish color. We'll see how that turns out. I don't want it to be aqua, though. That's the only thing. So let me add more cad yellow. Maybe a little more yellow ochre. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna get like a nice light green color. And what I'm gonna do is just load it with medium so that it's real loose, okay? And I'm just gonna have some of these pieces coming out here. Right, I can't do so much over the wood now. Right, have some of them bending. Okay, and I don't like how green that is. I want a little less green, so I'm going to add a little more yellow. Here, I think that's a better color. And so add some of these. Okay, maybe a little more medium because I need this to go over top smoothly. Okay, so the trick is to really have it watered down. And I could use a liner brush actually. I'm just afraid I'll end up getting too right. So the thing is, we just want to add these pieces of grass sticking up. Okay. Now I don't want it that green. I'm gonna bring in more yellow. I'm gonna bring in a little white. Okay, I really just have the yellow ochre now. Okay, so I'm just gonna put in a couple of these because we're gonna come back with a different color when they dry. I don't want them mixing, so we're gonna leave it at that. Another thing we can add right now for this stage of the painting is the some twigs. Okay, so I'm gonna take my medium, get a really loose burnt umber. Okay, and I'm just gonna come in here with some twigs. And that may be a little lighter than I want, so I'm gonna add a little black to it, I think. Yeah, I want a little darker. So let me add the dark to this. Okay. Just the idea, you know, that they're out in the field. Maybe even have one come in here. Alright. Okay. So, not a lot. I don't want to make it too busy with those things. And then I'm going to come in with a highlight a little bit on those. So I'm gonna drag a little white in this one. If this one's in front of it, maybe a little more on this side a bit here. Okay, and these come in, maybe these up here. Okay, so I'm dragging a little. It's gonna stay dark. In fact, I'm gonna make that a bit darker because it's coming from behind here. So I'm gonna put the barbed wire over top of this to show that it's behind it. And I'm gonna end this so it's clearly coming from behind it somewhere. Yeah. Okay, so we could even do a little darker, like down in this little niche. Okay, so now you can go in. I mean, these are really fine details, but you know what? If you're gonna do a painting, you might as well do the fine details. That's the way I see it. Okay, so adding a little in there. This back here could be a little darker. It's going behind this one, so. All right, I'm gonna bring this black back over top. There we go. Yep, yeah, I like that. You know what, let's do a little dark underneath here as well. Mix these. You know, especially we'll do dark right under here where this is maybe shadowed by this one. Yeah, there. You know, just giving them more life. In fact, I see this just really needs a, it's just calling for more black back here. Okay, this one I'm gonna have going over top, so I'm just gonna bring this one to here, really darken that, and I'm gonna make this there. Yeah, that's better. And I may even just lighten this up a little more so we can clearly tell that it's over top a bit. Yep. Okay. Okay, and we just want to add some more feathers. Some longer feathers coming down from here. So again, I'm taking my very small brush, a zero, and I'm gonna come in and put just some lighter feathers coming this way. Real tiny strokes, and they're not light enough, so let me add a little more white to this mixture. Lighten them up a little bit more. Okay, and I'm gonna come and just put a little more feathers coming down in here. It's hard to do a lot of detail when they're this tiny, but you would definitely see some. So I'm gonna put a little bit here and some more here. But I want to leave the dark orange in a lot of places. Okay, so I'm coming over the dark areas. Just a few feather strokes. See how just a few adds quite a lot? Remember that this brush is bigger than, way bigger than these birds. Okay, and come right over some of the dark areas. See how I'm just overlapping some of the dark? It's okay. Go right over them. Okay, and then I want to have some more white at the bottom, so I'm going to switch from my orange to just white. And go over those areas with a few white feathers. Okay, so right here at the bottom, I'm going to put a lot more white. Then I'm doing the white over top of, and let's start at the bottom. I'll do it this way. Okay, I'm going to do some white right down in here. Okay, and I want these to kind of overlap that dark area. Right, and bringing them up. And, you know, I want it to be whiter here, and it will be naturally because I have darker under the other areas. So let me just whiten that up some more. And then I can still come over here with my white. Okay, but I still want that even whiter. Let's see if I can get even whiter. In this area right here. Yeah. A little brighter. Okay. Maybe even just a little more next to it, but I do want that shadowed, so I'm not going to go too far. And then I want to get just a little more white under here. So I'm gonna dab a little under there. Okay, and the same with this one. They both have a little white up here, and I want to get that in. Let's do this up a little more. Bring that in a little bit. Okay. Yeah, I don't feel like this is feathery enough, so let me pull a little more. Okay. I'm gonna leave a little separation from that one there. Okay. And I have just a little bit of light I wanted on top of the head there, and I wanted a little on top of this one, so let me wipe off a lot of this paint and try to just... And then maybe just a few over here, but these are really behind the birds, so let's just do a little maybe catching here, a little up here. I got some like it's shining back over here on this side. I'll go ahead and do a little more. But then back here, I want this to stay dark, okay? And then we want a little more on our barbed wire. We have this nice and bumpy, like barbed wire. But we want to put those little rolls in, and we also need to put in this black to this mixture as well. I don't want it so dark that we can't see it though. So right under here, we're going to put some claws. Okay, and there's his feet. I'm going to try to put a highlight in there. Actually, I'm gonna need more light. Okay, so I got more light on it now. I can see it a little bit better. Okay, so we see them going around. I'm gonna let those dry before I can actually put in a little highlight right on the edge where they're wrapping around. Okay, so now I'm gonna grab the darker mixture that I made and start making those X's for the barbed wire. Okay, so there's another X right here. Okay, and we'll have to darken that up as well. And then we'll put another little roll of something sticking off here. Okay, see, we just leave like a little point. I'm not gonna overemphasize or do a lot with it, just in little areas. I'm gonna show just a little bit of point sticking out where the barbed wire's bending around. It's been rolled together, held together. Now these, remember, we're holding it on. So, and this was a really thick one here. So I want to address this I want to make this look more like a staple, so I'm going to come in here and I really need a noticeably whiter color. So I'm really going to have to lighten this up. Let me come in here and do the inside of the staple. Okay, now I have to do a black right over top of that. It's just too tiny for me to do. Okay, and then I had two more staples over here. Or it's more like a barbed wire or something. Go ahead and go over that and have that pointing. One more pointing there. And maybe go over this and make it a little darker. There. And darken this one too. I feel like it looks better darker. There. And it looks like the points of barbed wire. Okay, so with these birds, now this is going to be the hardest thing to do. I want to find a way to somehow get a white spot on each eye. That is going to be extremely hard to do without smudging that eye. So that's going to take white at the very tip of the brush and a very steady hand. Ooh, did it. Okay, now we're gonna try it on this one. Oh, I feel crazy doing this. All right, let me clean off the brush again. Get it to a nice tip, nice clean tip. In fact, I think I'll even, just to keep it that tiny, just kind of pull it into that pointed tip again. And then I'm gonna put it straight down into my pile of white and pull it straight back out. So it's right on the tip, and I'm going to try, oh Lord, help me with this. Did I get it on there? Oh, I can't tell. Okay. And I think I'm backing away every time I get close enough. Let's look at that again. Even with my glasses, I can't see this. Ooh, that's too much. Okay, well, no, maybe, no. Okay, so in a case like this, let's see. I could take a dry brush, a very pointed one, and I really don't have any that are very pointed. Mine are all use. I could try and go in and get a piece of it off with this. Let's see, but my eyes are blurring on me. I think I'm gonna leave it. It's not as good as the other one. It's actually getting more glare. Okay, I'm gonna leave it like that. But when I look at it, I still don't see enough white on this one. So I'm gonna try it again. Adjust my white. Try and get it just on the tip. Okay. And I turn my paintings, what's comfortable for me as a right-handed person. Okay. And you gotta reload a lot when you're using these tiny brushes, so don't keep trying to go and go. You have to come back and get more. Okay. And I'm gonna do a couple more up here. And I wanna make sure it's on the tip of my brush. Okay, so grab a little bit more orange. And bring it back there a little more. For orange. Still not dark enough. More like it. Shadow it a little more. Maybe that's what it means, yeah. Gives the appearance it's really darker orange feathers around the side. And these are just the fine details. You could have stopped a while ago, but I like to bring these out. You know, the more defined you go, the more realistic it starts to look. Let's see. The back of his head should be a little darker too. Yeah, there we go. There, that's a much nicer shape, Mr. Bird. And here should be quite dark. He has a very dark line under the fur here. So we'll darken that up a little bit. Yep, that's good. And this should be a little darker right at the base here. There. And then going down into these lines, a little darker at the top. And actually this one's dark all the way down. Yeah. Good. Very realistic. And he actually has a little feather that kicks out here. I don't know if that's the other wing coming around, but as I'm looking at a real bird, he's got that sticking out there. So I'll put that in. And it actually comes down kind of on a slope. Again here, that's pretty dark. We did good there. Now, we said we were going to put in just a little lighter grass before we had the, stand this up a little better, put this down. We have the lime green grass, okay? What's showing is more of a color of a yellow as the sun is hitting it, so we're going to get more of a yellow color. A lighter color here, light palish yellow. And just pull a couple of those through. You have to make this paint really watery, okay? So when you're doing these, you want them to flick and you want them to be really watery. So I'm gonna do a couple over like this. Okay, and maybe some really much taller ones. And that's still not light enough. Let me go even lighter. I want to really have a contrasting color here. Okay. This one I really wanted to bend over there. Okay, maybe have a couple coming this way from the outside. losing my water. See, it starts to get thick as soon as you lose the medium. You want to keep it loose, watery. And some of these kind of bend, like it's coming up and they've been bent. Okay, so I just want some to curve the other way. And some maybe that are coming. Yeah, I like this one. I want it to be a little more solid. Let's see if I can get a little thicker paint. Without getting fat. Okay. So I just want those variations of different colors. And I would say this painting is done. We don't want to cover up too much of the detail on the log because that, you know, that's a really good detail. Now we could put a little bit of ribbing, you know, a little highlight on some of the barbed wire where it bends around, curves around. Could do that here and there, maybe the outside of this. Okay, so it needs to be quite wet to stick to wet paint. So it's wet paint already, so to get this to stick to it's a little harder, especially here where I just did that. Okay, so put a couple more. Really there, that's a lot of shadow. This is really the only thing that's gonna get the sun very much. Maybe a little highlight on this. And maybe a little on these. Not too much, I don't want them to disappear with the highlight into the wood. So I think we're good there. And last thing to do is just sign it. Okay, I like to sign with kind of I always want a lighter color, but I'm gonna use what I used for the highlight in the grass and just bury my signature down in here. Okay, so my signature is just my initials run together. So I use part of the J as part of my N. And there's a Nash Mini. Just a fun, easy one.